players are after high stakes, but they'll have to avoid the whammy as they play the most exciting game of their lives. From Television City in Hollywood, it's time to press your luck. And now, here's your host, the star of Press Your Luck, Peter Tamarkin.
Thank you. Thank you, Ron Ruddy. Hi, everybody. Welcome once again to another episode of Press Your Luck, where we're always talking serious dollars. Right now, let's meet the three players who are vying for all the bucks today on Press Your Luck, starting with our returning champion, Sharon Carlton. How are you, Sharon?
Okay. I'm all right.
$9,250 in cash. What are your plans for all those bucks?
Pay some unpaid bills.
And have some left over, I hope.
Oh, yes, I'll have plenty left
plenty
over.
Left
I don't
over.
Have
maybe,
that many bills.
Maybe some more today.
I hope so.
All right, best of luck to you today, Sharon. Let's meet your two competitors. First is Tim Butler. How are you, Tim?
Good, Peter.
Where are you from?
From Los Angeles now, originally from Ohio, though.
And you recently learned how to fly.
Can you show us?
Right.
Well, if we beat the whammies.
Right. No, you did learn how to fly?
Yeah, for my birthday, I decided to do something different, so I went out and took lessons out at Santa Monica.
So do you have your plane, or do you just go out and
no,
rent?
No, I just go out and belong to a club, and then you go out and you rent it by the hour.
I see. So. That sounds like fun.
It's great.
Well, let me tell you something, Tim. The whammy flies, too.
I've seen the whammy, so, and he crashes.
See if you can shoot him down, all right?
All right.
Good luck to you today, Tim.
Thank you.
And our third player, Wesely Schiffman.
Hi,
Wesely. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Good. Now, speaking of shooting down whammies and crashing, you are a party crasher of sorts?
Sort of, yeah. I was in London, and it was on a Sunday, and I didn't know the pubs were closed, and I knocked on the door, and it was locked, and they let me in, and I found out that the pub owner was having a party, a going-away party. He was moving to the United States, and they thought I was there from the United States to say, you know, bon voyage to him, and I didn't even know it, and the name of the place was the Bloody Boar.
Doesn't sound like it was
No, it was fun.
You had a good time.
Mm-hmm.
Well, hopefully you'll have as much time, good time today on Press Your Luck.
Thank
all right?
You.
All right, good luck to you all. Are you ready? Because I have some questions and hopefully you have some answers. You give me a correct buzz and answer, it's worth three spins. A correct multiple choice answer, one spin. Are you ready?
Ready.
I don't hear anything.
Yes, ready!
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 Just check. I love when I do that. It makes me crazy. Okay. What fraction of all the single men in America between the ages of 20 to 55 who have never been married have also never lived with a woman? Wesely?
1/4.
Is the correct answer 1/4, 1/2, or 3/4? Sharon?
1/4.
1/4. What do you think, Tim? 1/4? The fraction of guys never married and never lived with a lady is 1/2.
Oh!
Yeah! Wow. 1/2. Did you know that? Oh, I didn't know it.
Well, where are they?
I didn't
they?
Know it. What do I know? What do any of us know?
Yeah, where are they?
Very esoteric question. All right. Second one. Let's see if you can do better on this one. Most of us know him as Macmillan from Macmillan and Wife, but he also starred in The Devlin Connection. Tim.
Rock Hudson.
Not to mention sharing the big screen with Doris Day in the classic film Pillow Talk. Who is this guy? Is it Rock Hudson, Tony Randall, or Eddie Albert, Sharon?
Rock Hudson.
Rock Hudson. Let's go to Wesley.
Rock Hudson.
That busy actor is indeed Rock Hudson. You got it. Sharon gets a spin. Tim Buzzin gets three. Wesley gets a spin. That's better. Here we go. According to the book, The Fine Art of Flirting, I must have missed it. What color blazer do they say a man should wear if he wants to make a good impression, Tim?
Blue.
On the ladies, is the correct answer blue, black, or gray, Sharon?
Blue.
Blue. Sharon goes with blue. What do you think, Wesley?
Blue.
Blue. Well, guys, the ladies will like you best in a blue blazer. Yeah. Sharon goes to two. Tim Buzzin goes to six. Wesley goes to two. Tim, it looks like you're in and I'm out. You've got blue and I've got this. Okay, last question. That's my problem. I found it out after 300 shows. What big southern city has been nicknamed Little Havana? Wesley?
Miami.
Is the correct answer Miami, Houston, or Atlanta?
Can you repeat the question?
What big southern city has been nicknamed Little Havana? Miami, Houston, or Atlanta?
Miami.
Miami. What do you think, Tim?
It's Miami.
Little Havana is a nickname from Miami, Florida. You got it. Sharon goes to three. Tim to seven. And Wesley buzzed in, so he goes to five. And all our players, you're going to get a chance to turn those pins into dollars when we come back after this. So don't be moving. We'll be right back. We're back to your first shot at the board, $13,000 on it, and other goodies and some baddies, the whammy. So stay away from the whammies. The player who ends this round with the most money gets to play last in the final round, and that gives you an advantage over everyone else. So you want to try to get that first place position. Remember, you can pass your remaining spins anytime during your turn if you have a fear of the whammy. Of course, four whammies will bring tears to your eyes, so avoid that. Fewest spins goes first. Sharon the champ with three of them. Let's hit it.
I'm ready for the big bucks. No whammy, stop.
Stop.
Oh, no.
Okay, Sharon, two spins, one whammy. You ready?
Yes, okay.
Here we go.
Stop!
Stop at $550. First place, one spin left, 550. Sharon, let's go.
Okay. No whammy, stop!
Stop at 300 and a spin. That's 850, and you still have your spin.
Do something with the spin. I'm going right. For it. Stop!
Stop at a whammy.
No!
All right, Sharon, two whammies, no dollars, and no more spins.
No.
So we now go to Wesely with five spins. Are you ready, Wesely?
I'm ready,
here
Peter.
We go.
I'm going to press my luck. Come on, big bucks. No whammies, stop.
Stop at $500. Four spins, press your luck or pass.
I'm going to press my luck, Peter. Come on, big bucks. I need big bucks. No whammies, big bucks, stop.
Stop at $1,250. That's the buck, $1,750. Yeah. Three spins left.
I'm going to go for it, Peter.
All right, here we go.
I'm going to press my luck. No whammies, stop!
Stop at $350, you're at $2,100. Two spins, you have $2,100 more than anyone. What's your pleasure?
I'm gonna press my luck, Peter.
Press my luck, here we
okay.
go.
Okay. Come on, big bucks, no whammies, stop!
Stop at
all.
Bad. He's
yes.
bad. One whammy, one spin. Wesely took the $2,100 away.
Press my luck.
Go.
Okay, no more whammies. They're out of the way now. We want big bucks. Stop.
Stop at $200 and a spin. Back in first place with one spin left.
I'm gonna press my luck
all right,
here.
Going again.
Okay, no whammies. All gone now. We want big bucks. Only stop.
Stop at $1,250. You got it back.
Yeah.
$1,450. You have first place. We've yet to hear from Tim with seven spins. Tim?
Okay, let's go. No whammies, stop!
Stop at 550. Second place,
okay.
Six spins. Press your luck.
Press
pass.
My luck, Peter. Okay, no whammies, and stop!
Stop at 525. That's going
right.
to be up to 1,075. Five spins, second
going,
place, going again.
And stop!
Stop at a reclining rocker.
Right.
You don't look like you need it, Tim. But it's worth $329. That brings you up to 1,404. That's $46 less than Wesely, four spins.
I'm going to press my luck.
All right.
Okay, no whammies, and stop!
Stop at 750.
Yeah.
First place. You have 2154, three spins.
Okay, I'm gonna press my
pressing
luck.
On.
Come on, no whammies, and stop.
Stop at 300 and a spin, 2454. Still have your three spins, Tim. Press your luck or pass. In first place by $1,000.
I'm gonna pass my spins.
Pass them, they go to Wesely. Three to you, Wesely. Let's see if it's a gift or a curse. Here we go.
Okay.
Stop at $500. So far, so good. $1,950. Second place. Two more spins. You have to take them. Here they come.
Okay. Press my luck. Big bucks. No whammies. Stop.
A curse.
One of my tips. Two of my guys. The whammies are coming to steal your stash.
All right. Strategic game here. Wesely, two whammies, $0, one spin. You want to be careful about picking up a third whammy in round one. Now, you have one spin left. You can pass it to Tim, or you can try to go for it yourself.
I'm going to press my luck.
Pressing on. Wesely, okay. Here she goes.
Big bucks. No whammies. Stop.
Stop at advanced two spaces to a microwave oven. And that value of that oven is $379. Maybe you can put the whammy in it. And Sharon, $0. Tim, $2,454. You have first place. The advantage, you've got first place. So we're coming right back with a whole new round after these words. So let's see what you do with the answers to these questions. Hopefully you'll earn some spins. Are you ready?
Uh-huh.
Here we go. Her new book is called Babe, and in the movie, she was both Victor and Victoria, not to mention Darling Lily and Mary Poppins. Who is this, Tim?
Julie Andrews.
Lady, is the correct answer Julie Andrews, Audrey Hepburn, or Lee Remick, Sharon?
Julie Andrews.
Let's go over to Wesely and see what she says.
Julie Andrews.
That lovely actress who is now an authoress is Julie Andrews. That is correct. Sharon gets a spin, Tim Buzzin gets three, and Wesely gets a spin. Second question. We have U.S. embassies all over the globe. Is the top diplomatic officer of the embassy called a consul, an ambassador, or a foreign minister, Sharon?
Ambassador.
Is the correct answer ambassador, consul, or foreign minister, Tim?
Foreign minister.
Foreign minister. What do you think, Wesely?
Foreign minister.
Well, the top guy in an embassy is the ambassador.
All right.
Sharon knows, and she goes to four. We go to the third question. If you are a pugilist, from what activity do you make your living? All right, I'll try it again and give it to you in multiple choice. Obviously, none of you are into it. All right. If you're a pugilist, from what activity do you make your living? Fishing, boxing, or dancing? Sharon?
Dancing.
Dancing.
Fishing.
Tim? Fishing.
Fishing.
You guys are out of your skulls. Muhammad Ali was a dancer, but he was a fighter, a boxer. Yeah. No spins. That's I had a good time. You guys didn't. Okay. Last question. At the present time, what's the youngest age you can legally drink alcohol in America, Sharon?
21.
Is the correct answer 21, 16, or 18, Tim?
18.
Tim says it's 18.
18.
Wesely says it's 18. The youngest drinking age is 18. That's correct. Sharon stays at four, Tim goes to four, and Wesely goes to two. And that's the last question. Who's better to take those pins to the board? See if they can make some big bucks right after this. Come on back. So hard for this final opportunity. It is the opportunity to win, well, there's over $80,000 in cash up there in that big board just waiting for you to climb all over it and take away the money. There's one prize up there worth more than $5,000. It is an automobile. All right, so maybe you can drive home. Don't forget the whammy. However, he is up there along with his lovely, well, maybe bride-to-be, Tammy. We're not going to really let the cat out of the bag, as it were. But she's up there with him as well, and they'll take away all your dollars, so be very careful. Now, the player with the most money is going to play last. Sharon with $0, Wesely with $379. Don't qualify. Guess who's going to play last? Yes. Yes, folks, it's Tim. With $24.54, you won the first round, so you're going to play last. It gives you strategy. You can sit back and plan your strategy. I know you have a great plan in mind. We're going to go to Sharon, who is a champ with $0, four spins, two whammy. Sharon, you ready? Let's get it. Big bucks.
I'm ready. No whammies. No whammies. I have enough. I need the money. Stop.
Stop it. Move one space to $1,500 and a spin or $2,500.
I'll take the 15 and the spin.
15 and a spin. And Sharon wants more spins.
I need the
1,500.
Money, yes.
Second place.
Spin.
Four spins, Sharon.
I need the money. I need the car. Stop.
Stop at Miami. A trip to Miami. Little Havana. Worth $1,470. $2,970. First place,
luck.
Sharon. Here we go.
My luck. I need a car.
Stop it to go back two spaces at $3,000 and a spin. $5,970. Sharon, you still have three spins. Going again.
I want to go. Oh, I need a car. Oh, no whammies. No whammies. Stop.
Stop it. Double your money and a spin. Sharon, you doubled your money. You have $11,940 and you got a spin. You're in first place by over $9,000. You're about $9,500 in the first place, Sharon. What do you want to do?
I think I'm passing them.
You're going to pass. All right, they go to you, Tim.
I'm passing them.
You're sure now. They're yours, Tim. Three spins to you, no longer Sharon. And now we go to Wesely with $379 and two spins. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Are you ready? What's ready?
Okay.
Stop at $1,500. Wesely,
okay.
$1,879, third place, one spin.
Okay, press my luck. Come on, big bucks, no whammy, stop.
Stop at $1,500 and a spin, staying alive. Good name for a song, $3,379, one spin left, you are in second place.
Now if I pass it,
you passed, we'll go to Sharon. Play with the highest amount of money. You are in second place.
Press my luck.
Press on.
Okay.
Here she goes.
Big bucks, no whammies, big bucks.
spin. You had a good premonition, Wesley. You're now up to $6,379. Still have the one spin. Now you're passing
pass
it, Sharon.
Pass.
Passing it to you, Sharon. Let's see what she gave you. Here we go. $11,940 on the line. Stop at 1,000 and a spin. $12,940. You have one spin you can take or pass.
Pass
it back, Wesley.
You can have it.
Back to you. Turn about a spare play. Let's see what she gave you. $6,379. One spin. Here you go.
Okay. Press my luck. Come on. Big bucks. Big bucks. Big bucks. No whammy. No whammy. This is for everyone that's counting on me. Come on. Big bucks. Stop.
Stop at 1,500 big bucks, Wesley. You're up to $7,879, second place to Sharon. We now go to Tim, who has $2,454 and three spins passed to him by Sharon. And here they come one at a time, Tim.
Okay, no whammies, no whammies, big bucks, and stop.
Stop at $750. Moving up on him, Tim.
Right. Okay.
$3,204, two spins. Here we go.
Okay, no whammies, no whammies, and stop.
Stop at a whammy. Oh, there it is. You must have learned about your flying, Tim. Yeah. Well, you have five spins, $0, one whammy. What do you want to do?
I'm going to press my luck.
Here we go.
Okay, come on, Ford. Be good to me now. Come on, no whammies, big bucks, and stop.
Stop it. Big bucks. $4,000 and a spin. You have this third place, $4,000. You still have your five spins, Tim.
I'm going to press my luck here. Okay, come on. Good, no whammies, big bucks, and stop.
Stop at $1,000 and a spin. You move it up. $5,000, you have five spins, Tim.
I've got to keep going,
Moving
Peter.
On.
Okay, come on. No whammies, no whammies, no whammies, and
stop it. Doing a little runway clearing, I guess. Tim, four spins, no dollars, two whammies. What do you want to do now?
I'm going to press my luck. Press
on. All right, here we go.
Okay, come on, Ford. Be good to me now. Come on, and stop.
Stop at a motorbike.
All right.
Tim, that motorbike has a value of $1,298. Third place, three spins. Press your luck or pass.
Gotta press
again.
My luck, Peter.
Tim, okay, second place on, to do some maneuvering.
Bucks. Come on, and stop.
Stop at $2,250. Okay. That's some bucks. You're now up to $3,548. Two spins left, third place. Going again. Need some big bucks
big
here.
Big bucks. I've got to have the big bucks on the spin. Come on, and stop.
Stop at home. In case you want to know, that's a pugilist. Tim, three whammies, no dollars, one spin. You're going to
go?
You're
going
to have to get something that gives you an additional spin in order to stay in the game. If you don't, Sharon will be the champion once again. Are you ready, Sharon?
Yeah!
Tim, big bucks, here we go.
We need a spin, and stop.
Stop at 700 and a spin, you got it. 700 and a spin, third place, one spin left. What are you
going
to do, Tim?
We got it.
Going again, Sharon, hang on, he needs another spin.
He
needs another spin, 750 and a spin and gets it, 1450. Still has to spin slowly but surely, Tim. Same predicament. You need something that gives you an additional spin to stay in the game.
Sharon's a champ. Come on, no way. Stop.
Stop it. Washington, D.C. is not enough. Tim and Sharon, you are the champ again today with $12,940. Congratulations. We'll come back and talk about your winnings right after these words. We're back with today's big press your luck winner, Sharon, with $12,940. Sharon, you get to hear the dulcet tones of the one, the only, the illustrious one, Rod Roddy. Go for it, Rod.
Thank you, Peter. Sharon, you've won a holiday in Miami. We'll fly you and your guest round trip coach from Los Angeles to Miami, Florida for a six-night stay, modified American plan, at the Lifters Marco Polo Oceanfront Hotel. Relax and enjoy their food, a private beach, three restaurants, two nightclubs, and a shopping arcade from the Marco Polo Hotel. That prize totaling $1,470, combined with the $11,470 in cash you won today, and the $9,250 in cash you won previously, gives you a grand total, Sharon, of $22,190. Congratulations!
Sharon, what a hunk of cash! Well done, and you get to do it again. You get to come back here. I got a feeling you've just started to fight. Congratulations.
Ooh,
now, Tim and Wesley, You will not be leaving empty-handed. We've got some nice prizes for you. I thank you for being with us on Press Your Luck. And until next time when we see Sharon, this is Peter DeMorgan saying thanks for pressing your luck. Bye-bye.
Speaking for Press Your Luck, a Carruthers Company presentation.